blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. When I'm found in the desert place, though I walk through the wilderness, blessed be your name.
This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Greetings. I am Deborah Lucas, pastor of Harmony United Methodist Church in Hamilton, Virginia, and I greet you in the name of our risen Lord Jesus Christ. We are living in times that are unlike anything we have experienced before. Our personal lives are turned upside down, our professional lives are turned upside down, and our church lives are turned upside down. And I come to you this morning from an office in our church. I bring you what I hope for you are words of hope that are important to me. And the words of hope that I begin with are, on Christ, the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. My dad was a farmer in the mountains of West Virginia. If you've come to our church and heard me speak, you will know that my dad was a farmer and that I'm a mountain girl. One of the things my dad did later in his life was that he collected rocks. He appreciated nature in whatever form it took. He appreciated the trees and the rivers and the mountains. And you know what? He appreciated rocks. I actually have a collection of rocks that my dad had picked up over the years, and I'm surrounded by these rocks this morning. I'm holding one of them, and the rocks are behind me beside the cross. It may seem strange to collect rocks, but Daddy collected rocks because they would be unique or interesting in some way. Like this one, it kind of looks like a boot, or it could look like one of those oil lamps that was used in Jesus's time. Daddy would collect rocks that showed the mineral veins running through them, and he just brought them home because he thought they were pretty and they were interesting. When Daddy died, my mother had this humongous box of rocks and she didn't know what to do with them. So I said, I'll take the rocks. Well, I am a United Methodist pastor, which means I get moved a lot. And so when my husband and I would move from church to church, he would look at me and say, are you taking this box of rocks with you? And I would say, yes, as a matter of fact, I am taking these box of rocks with me. My plan had been to plant the rocks around our gardens, but with moving, I didn't want to leave the rocks behind. And so today I have these rocks with me, and I have them not only to remind me of my dad, but also to remind me of the foundation upon which he and my mother built our family. A solid foundation, a foundation that stood firmly in the midst of storm, a foundation that holds our family for generations to come. This brings me to the scripture that we're using today, a scripture from Matthew. Many of you, I'm sure, are familiar with this scripture. The scripture comes at the end of Jesus's teaching, the Sermon on the Mount. Through the Sermon on the Mount, he has given us these ethical instructions of how we as Christians are to live in relationship with one another and to relationship with God. And this is what he says at the very end of the Sermon on the Mount. He speaks these words to the crowd who are gathered around him, and he speaks these words to us today. Hear these words from Matthew. And Jesus says, everybody who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise builder who built a house on bedrock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the wind blew and beat against the house. It didn't fall because it was firmly set on bedrock. But everybody who hears these words of mine and doesn't put them into practice will be like a fool who built a house on sand. The rain fell, the winds came, the floods came, and that house, it fell. It fell and was completely destroyed. These are the words of God for us, the people of God. As we hear these scriptures, we find, first of all, that there are two things in common with these people building the homes. First of all, they are people of action. Perhaps this was their dream homes they were building, but they were taking action. They were doing what they wanted to do. The second thing is that both of these homes were threatened by severe storms. And then we come into the differences of these two people. The first one, the wise one, who built his home upon the rock, it withstood the storms of life. The second one, the foolish one, that built upon the shifting sands that move and float around when water and wind hits it, well, his house fell. One was foolish and one was wise. Our first inclination might be to think that Jesus is speaking about those who hear his words but don't come to faith in him. But if we listen to these words more closely, we hear that Jesus is speaking to those who hear his words, who hear his teachings, but do not put them into practice. Jesus says, everybody who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a builder who builds his house upon solid bedrock. Jesus is wanting us to hear that we who hear his words, who take them in, are to put them into practice. Those who build their houses upon the shifting sand, those builders are the ones who hear his words but don't put them into practice. They are the ones who are hearers of the words and not doers of the words. In James 1:22, James tells us to be hearers and doers of the word. And this is what Jesus is telling us and wants us to hear in this scripture from Matthew. Jesus expects us to be people of action. Jesus is setting the bar for what he wants for us. He wants us to put our faith into practice. The ancient Greeks had a way of viewing maturity. Knowledge was learning certain truths. Understanding was grasping these truths so that one could articulate them. And wisdom was taking these truths and putting them into action. It was doing them. This is what we hear Jesus saying. He is saying to us, you are wise when you hear my teachings and you do them. When you put into practice all that I have taught you. These last few weeks have challenged us in ways we would have found unimaginable months ago. Our home lives, our professional lives, our children's school lives, our healthcare systems are challenged and strained, and we wonder what to do. We look for words of wisdom from our professional healthcare workers, and they give us guidance on how we should live. We are to practice social distancing. We stay at home as much as possible. Avoid large crowds. Don't go out if we're sick. And above all, wash our hands. Keep our hands clean. Stay away and avoid this virus as much as possible. We listen to those words of wisdom and we put that wisdom into practice. Ireland and Journey began on Wednesday, February the 26th. The scriptures that we've been using through Lent have come from the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew. And we began Ash Wednesday by hearing the Beatitudes. Throughout this Lenten journey, we have heard Jesus encourage us to be faithful in prayer and to pray with integrity. He has told us to forgive others as we have been forgiven. He encourages us to love our enemies. He challenges us to be peacemakers and to show mercy. He reminds us that we are the salt of the earth and the light for the world. He tells us to ask and it will be given, to seek and we will find, to knock and the door will be answered. And today we hear these words from Matthew at the conclusion of the Sermon on the Mount, when Jesus tells us that we who hear what he has said in the Sermon on the Mount, to put them into practice, and we will be the wise person who has built our house upon the rock. Jesus is the solid rock upon which we stand. He is the foundation of our faith. Much like my dad was the foundation of our family, and the rocks that I have gathered around me remind me of the strength of that foundation. The words that Jesus speaks, the truth that he has, it is wise for me to remember them and to practice them. Jesus is with us during this difficult time, and our hope is built on nothing less than Jesus, and he is the solid rock upon which we stand. Jesus is our sure foundation. This is what gives us hope. This is what gives us hope that there is a light at the end of the tunnel in this time of anxiety. Jesus' words are what calm the storms that rage within us. Jesus' words are give us the comfort that we can sleep peacefully at night, and others need to hear these words from us. We need to offer them the same words of hope, to be the wise builder and put our faith into action by offering these words of hope and encouragement. Brothers and sisters, Christ is the solid rock upon which we stand, and he is our firm foundation. Friends, Jesus wants us to be the wise builder and to put our faith into practice. A way that we do this through Harmony United Methodist Church is through our mission ministry. I invite you to check our website. There you will find links and other information about how you may be able to help our brothers and sisters in our community. There are those who are less fortunate than we who could use our help. Friends, I invite you to join with me as I pray. Holy and gracious God, in this time of silence, we sense your presence. The power of your Holy Spirit is at work. It's working in ways that we don't even know. Your Spirit moves through individuals to bring healing. Your Spirit brings through individuals to bring hope. Your Spirit moves to bring comfort and peace and encouragement and strength. Jesus teaches us to be people of hope. He encourages us to be doers and not just hearers of his word, but to put into practice everything that he teaches us. And he's taught us to pray, and so we pray. He has taught us to forgive because we have been forgiven, and so we forgive. He has taught us to be peacemakers and to show mercy. He has demonstrated to us a servanthood that is to be modeled by us, a servanthood that is challenging under normal circumstances, but is extremely challenging now. Our lives are disrupted. Lives of people worldwide are disrupted. People are sick. People are dying. Healthcare workers are working around the clock 24/7 to tend to those who are sick and dying. We give you thanks for those who are recovering and have recovered from this terrible virus. We pray for your healing peace to bring some comfort in the midst of these struggles. We pray for our leaders and our world leaders to find ways to get the machines, the necessary paper products, clothing, medicine, whatever is needed to our clinics and our hospitals. We pray for our medical staff. We pray for those who have lost jobs in this crisis. We pray that we can be people who reach out and care for them, knowing that we have to think outside the box and find ways to bring food and clothes and hope. We pray for those who are working from home. We pray for our children who are out of school and for our teachers. We pray for our community leaders, our state leaders, our national leaders, and our global leaders. We pray you bring comfort to those who have lost loved ones. We pray that you use us. Holy God, I pray too that you help keep us in hope, trusting that in the midst of this, you are working. Work within us this morning. Help us to build our homes upon Christ. Help us to stand surely upon his foundation. Help us to trust and believe in such ways that regardless of what happens, we know he is with us. We pray for your people everywhere. We pray for our churches. Holy and gracious God, in these next few moments of silence, allow each person to lift up their prayers to you right now. We pray our prayer in Jesus' name. He who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit rest upon you and give you comfort and peace and security and calmness. Stay planted upon the strong rock foundation of Jesus. Amen.